checklist and fill in all these pledges and it's all the virtual thank you for praising. And then so you're meant to fill in them, but and then you go into end and then it comes up your orders on its way.
But CoderDojo set up a year ago. It's a really, really cool movement to turn Ireland into an economy of sort of high tech, you know, young programmers, which that outlet isn't really there at the moment. So one of the things that we seen was, you know, growing up, you know, kids love sport and they get the opportunities to, you know, play Gaelic or rugby. But, you know, if a kid has an interest in computers, where could they go? Like, so CoderDojo has really sort of been set up on that premise to give that outlet to kids to, if you want to learn programming, you know, there's going to be professionals there that across the country with passionate about computers that will teach you like the coolest stuff that there is on the market.
CoderDojo is a movement. It's a step forwards. It's a different thing from classrooms. It's a club. And it's open source, which means that kids can, or individuals can bring it and take it as a template, a model. And, for instance, it was set up in Cork just as a place for kids to come along, learn about computers. And that basic operating environment can be taken and used in other locations.
CoderDojo was kind of an environment for kids who want to learn how to program. So they have regular meetups on Saturdays. They learn all sorts of languages like HTML and Scratch.
So quite often what you find is kids will come, they'll start in the beginners group, they'll stay there for maybe 5 weeks, and after maybe five Saturdays of being there, you'll find a new kid will arrive and they'll actually be teaching them. It won't be the mentors anymore, it'll be the kids teaching each other, you know, which is really a fabulous experience, both for the children who are teaching the new kids that come along and for the kids to be taught by another child, because they feel it's something fun that kids like to do and not just a grown-up, you know, not another thing like school or not another class.
We learn from other children and mentors. We learn about Scratch, HTML, CSS, Python, you know, all those sort of things, and it's really great fun.
The mentoring is brilliant. All the mentors give up their own time to come in on a Saturday for 2 or 3 hours and teach these kids to code. It's phenomenal.
There's really strong ethos within CoderDojo, so one of the key things is the movement is free. So we give our time up for free, so it's no barriers to entry. That's a really important part of us. So anyone who wants to learn, get onto CoderDojo.com. Look at the closest one to you and just show up some Saturday.
It's already in 115 locations around the world. We've got Japan, Sweden, Uganda, we've got Russia, Tokyo, it's everywhere.
It's spread internationally. We have something like 60 dojos in Ireland. I think there's 3 in Dublin, in the Science Gallery, in UCD, and then there's a few others around the city as well.
I made a game on Sprite and just wanted to show it to you. To control it, you have to press up to fly and side to side to go left or right.
Where did you pick up your programming skills?
I taught myself.
What have you done? Are you a web developer? Where do you work?
I'm a back-end and API developer.
She's learning HTML for probably around 6 or 8 months now. Building her own website and starting to learn how gaming and all that sort of stuff. So,
at what age is Mia?
Mia's 11.
We have anything from 6-year-olds up to 18-year-olds, really, in our CoderDojo in Cork. I think all the dojos are pretty much the same. The typical age where they're able to type on a computer and able to spell a little bit is when they can start.
If they can read and understand what's going on a board, they can start learning from there. Upper ages, we say we're a youth movement, we get up to about 18 on average. We have had people in the class, I think there was one lady that was about 70 in one of the classes and just wanted to be there to learn, so we don't in any way discriminate against age. You want to learn how to program a computer, we'll teach you.
The structure of our economy has been changing so dramatically in recent years, and there's no doubt about it but that the future is in digital enterprises of one kind or another. Now, CoderDojo and so on is, we're talking about people at the other end of the spectrum for whom digital literacy, you know, they take to it like ducks to water, and so on. But the future of this economy in terms of, you know, exploiting the fact that the major ICT companies are located here, that we have a very literate young population, and we are improving our broadband infrastructure all the time, that undoubtedly is the way to add value in the future and to trade services that were unthinkable a short few years ago.
I think it could give us a great future if we wanted to do a bit of programming, and I think it's going to obviously help if we learn from a young age. So I'm 12 years old, and hopefully maybe in 10 years' time I might be quite big at programming.
I would have been a person who only learned how to program when I went to university. I suppose looking back now, I realise how hard that was with a 60% dropout rate in universities. It's a very, very hard subject to take up, so we've taken a different approach at it. How about we teach something that's cool and just sort of teach it in a cool way, not theory. Forget the theory. You know, the theory will come based on the practical output that the kids are seeing.
What I was absolutely gobsmacked about in our CoderDojo last week was the kids took a remote-controlled toy that they bought in Smith's that rolls along and just, you know, you can direct it by moving it left or right with a little joystick button on a remote control. They completely dismantled it. They put in a little chip called an Arduino, and they put it into this little remote control toy. They hooked it up to their laptop initially via a USB cable, and they were able to give it an artificial intelligence so it could make up its own mind which way to go along the floor. It's the most amazing thing ever. So after that, they managed to sort it out to do it remotely, so they could just walk around the room as long as they were within range of this little remote control toy and let it roll, say, it would roll over maybe 20 steps this way or 20 steps that way, and then it would change its mind and go somewhere else. And it was just exploring the room, basically, and it was really phenomenal. And I mean, these were kids that are age 10 and 11, you know, they're not like 18-year-olds or third-level education students, they're primary school children.
CoderDojo's plan is to always teach what's cool. So one of the key things we're going to do is we're going to continue the platform of teaching only on what the kids see cool. So we started with web design and Scratch, we're going on to HTML games, we're then going to go on to Android development and iPhone development. We're not going to teach you how to build an insurance system. We're going to teach you what's cool. So as long as we can keep that cool ethos and go through those subjects, the kids will pick up Java in that, they'll pick up Objective-C in that, they'll pick up JavaScript. You know, they all sit in behind what these sort of cool items are.
Really, it's just so organic. It just flows. It's the word is inexorable. It just you can't stop it.
Where do you hope it's going to take you? What do you hope to do with it?
Well, hopefully I'll be the CEO of the company, essentially.
So you can move around and go through the shoot and... Hey.